Evan joins us now. Tal?
Who don't know you?
Derek, David, about 100 New Yorkers gathered here in St. Paul's Chapel in Lower Manhattan to show that they cannot stand idly by. They cannot no longer be indifferent to the suffering of the civilian in Eastern Ghouta, as you mentioned, and in the entire country of Syria. They gathered here, Muslims, Jews, and also Christians. We see people of faith coming here together to raise awareness to the situation. They're not focused on the political aspects of the war in Syria. By the way, going into its eighth year right now, this March marks the seventh anniversary of the war in Syria. But what they are focusing about is the humanitarian aspect of the war in Syria. They want to bring awareness to the medical situation of people in Eastern Ghouta. They are reading names of people who died while waiting for urgent medical care over here. They are distributing this picture, for example, of a two-year-old kid, baby, I should say, whose right leg has been amputated over there. And I'm joined here by Tara Karangulu. She's an international journalist and also a supporter of this organization who organized this vigil tonight, the Syrian Faith Initiative. Tara, we are here in New York, thousands of miles away from Syria. What do you think that this impact of such a vigil could be? What are people gathered here hoping to achieve?
You know, what's so incredible about this event in particular is that people who are here in personal capacity. I mean, myself as a journalist, you know, we're here to support the human aspect and the humanitarian crisis that's ongoing in Syria. Since 2013, this past 48 hours have been the worst. You know, we have seven hospitals that have been attacked just this past week. The death toll is rising, and the rabbis and the priests and the activists that you see behind me, almost all of them are medical doctors. So they are coming together to really move beyond the political rhetorics that we often wait for in seeing results or change in Syria. So they're coming together to really bring in the humanity that New Yorkers feel and share towards what's going on in Syria.
What is the main message coming out of here tonight in terms of the United States? We heard some of the speakers calling for President Trump to do something, but what is the United States doing in terms of the humanitarian crisis?
That's actually the biggest issue right now in Al-Ghouta. If you look at Ghouta, it's smaller than Manhattan. And what we are witnessing is a lack of humanitarian aid and the continuation of bloodshed. So the activists here are calling for the immediate medical evacuation of the people who are awaiting potential death.
Thank you so much for this, Sarah. David, Derek, a small vigil indeed, but very powerful when three faiths come here together.